So I had this patient, right? And she had one of these anterior anatomates, a forward anatomate, rotating around a transverse axis, if you will. And when we looked at the muscular system, something attached to it, something that could pull it down in that same direction, because if it's held forward, there's something in the front, more than likely, that can pull down to do that. And it just so happened we had a rectus femoris muscle that was short. End of story, problem solved. Siri, play a rim shot? No? Okay, anyways. Of course, it's not that easy. That's way too simple. The complexity in the body is just, would never allow for that. So the reality was, it was a short, specifically tendon, proximal tendon of that rectus femoris muscle. That's a leg muscle, one of the quadriceps there. And when that muscle gets short, certainly it could pull on that anatomic bone, this big hip bone, that's not the actual name, but this big hip bone. It's very possible for it to do that, making it so that we can't push it backwards. That's the test. And do remember, this is a anatomic on sacrum motion. It can do that, but it's not really going to do that in this position. Not by any means. Standing position is a little too easy, because we actually have a fair amount of slack in these tissues right here. And in fact, the kneecap that floats right on top of the combined tendon of that and the vastus muscles, it's very easy for it just to be lifted up. That's where the slack is. That's where it would be taken from. So we wouldn't really get much of an anterior anatomate in this case, just from that alone. It's too simple. So instead, we get rid of this and we put it like this, because this walking position does a little bit more for us. It does a little bit more for that anatomate, because we've changed the angles of pull and the stretch that's occurring. So when we're walking, the rectus femoris, as it attaches into through that, obviously patella, but through that patella and the shared tendon, it will be on greater stretch, because now the lower limb, tibia, fibula, have gone into a little bit of knee flexion. And so this means the rectus femoris is longer. Now it can't just pull the kneecap up. It can't be just that this elongates, because it's already pre-elongated. The fact that we have a shortened tendon in this area means that it will concentrate the forces more onto the anatomate. The anatomate will now be tugged. And this isn't from extreme running. This isn't from extreme sports. It's just the slow and gradual buildup of a pull over time. It didn't take just one really hard pull. It was not just all one giant pull. That would be, you know, unrealistic. There would be a trauma behind that. There would be a noticeable incident before and after the problem. This is something that slowly built up, potentially over weeks to months to years, drawing that anatomate more and more forward, just bit by bit. Tiny, tiny little motions. It also points out an interesting fact. It drives home another fact that the muscles are not these completely singular structures. They actually have different bands and fibers. And we can certainly break down the quadriceps into a bunch of different fibers. Of course we can do that. But individually, those muscles can be further broken down into regional areas. Whether the rectus femoris, we have the more front, back, or side, or even chunking it out sectionally, because all of these different areas, despite the fact that they pull in the same direction, may be regionally stuck, maybe contracting in a certain spot more than another, maybe thickened and fibrosed at the upper end versus the lower end. And so this is why your palpation skills, your ability to detect where the real problem is coming from, is so vitally important to what you do and how you make an effective correction. That was Elge. This is Simple Lines Anatomy. That maybe made sense. I don't know anymore.